evening, everyone, and welcome to the Misfit Toy Fantasy Football League recap show. Kids are asleep. It's late at night, Wednesday night. So one thing they didn't tell you about being parents was that Christmas vacation was not a vacation. I've been working harder these last 3 days than I did all school year so far, but it's been fun. I'm going to be sore tomorrow. We went sledding today. Yesterday we went to the science center, had basketball practice each day. I'm rocking my sweet throwback dolphin shirt. I mean, how cool is that? Why did they change their mascot? It looks ridiculous now. Go back to this. Got a few retro shirts from Santa Claus. Also rocking the old burr head just out of the shower look. So hopefully you guys are having a great Christmas vacation, holiday vacation, winter vacation, whatever you want to call it. I am doing fine tonight, drinking a little bit, one of my favorite beverages. My winter beverage of choice. We won't discuss that right now, but you want to know what it is? Hit me up. I'll let you know. Anyway, what a week in the Misfit Toy League. Holy cow. The championship game is set, and those two semifinal games were intense. Intense for me anyways. I don't know if they're intense for anybody else, but we are set for the championship game. We are set, almost set for the Ruby Ducey. We got to kind of go over that guy a little bit, but let's look at the scoreboard from this week in the consolation bracket. Said it right this time. Consolation bracket. Angie Krug took down Nathan Neward 148 to 137. Also, Nathan Neward. Holy cow. I've only had a couple of drinks of this, but Nathan Newhard, still rocking that waiver wire. He stole Tyler Algier from me today. I was really depending on him to be on my roster. So, Nathan, if you're watching this and you're not going to play Tyler Algier, please drop him so I might have a chance to pick him up. But, yeah, I was really banking on him to be in my lineup this week. But Nathan's still rocking that waiver wire, which is good. He's looking to win his matchup next week as he fell to Angie 148 to 137 this week. Angie Lutenegger took down Leanne 136 to 132. TJ Hawkinson from Sheraton, Iowa. I was about to say Glendale, Iowa. Sheraton, Iowa, just down the road. Former Hawkeye, 40 points led the way for Angie. Team Sheehan, glad to see he took that early exit because he's been playing well. 184-109 over Ryan Joe Burrow, a huge game for him. The Teely bounced back in his consolation matchup, 122 to 120 over Fail Mary. Nick took down Dora coming in hot, 142 to 102. And Amy KP took down Brad, 126 to 88. Again, those are the consolation games. You guys just playing out the string and, you know, just having some fun playing that waiver wire as Nathan did earlier. Man, that was heartbreaking today when I saw it. I didn't get old Tyler, but it is what it is. I got to roll with the team I have in the Ruby Ducey playoffs. All right. So we got a lot to dissect here, to unpack here in this matchup. This week's games, Tyler took down Matt 128 to 101, and Ankeny Natron took down Jeanette 137 to 64. So that puts our Ruby Ducey standings at Michael at 2-1, Matt at 2-1. Sorry, looking down at my nose. Jeanette at 1-2, and Nathan at 1-2. So going into this week's game, there could be a four-way tie with record-wise in the Ruby Ducey. That way we'd go to playoff total points, and the lowest point total would be the Ruby Ducey winner. If one person comes up with three losses in the Ruby Ducey, they are the outright winner. We could have a four-way tie if Jeanette and Nathan can both win this week, which is a possibility. So the Ruby Ducey heating up. Don't want that thing in your classroom, even though it is pretty cool. It's a prize. On to the two semifinals in the winner's bracket. Holy cow, these two were good ones, and both of them went back and forth. You watch the probability back and forth. To start out with, Becky Hazy and Tyler, they were slated to go pretty close. Becky was the favorite, and then all of a sudden Tyler ran off with a bunch of points, and he was the favorite. But then he was done. He didn't have anybody left, and Becky had a couple players left. And all of a sudden Becky tilted back to be the leader. But it came down to the last game And Tyler had a 125.57 lead over Becky, who had like 119. Her guy pulled off about 6 points, and he ended up being a 0.02 difference. Tyler hung on 125.57 to 125.05.02. And that is, we've had some close matches this year. That one is the closest we've had, and it came in the semifinals. And it was that home field advantage that put Tyler over the top. He and I were texting back and forth. He said he didn't have much of a shot. He didn't think he held on. It was nuts that he was able to hold on to that win. But Tyler, the number one seed, survived. That's why I played some Destiny Child. I'm a survivor. If you didn't pick that up at the beginning. But Tyler survives by 0.02 points to make it the championship game. Who would he face? Came down between me and Kevin, Team Hawkeye. Again, one of those ones that went back and forth. I was favored a lot to begin with. Then all of a sudden, Kevin was favored a lot. I was favored a lot. During that last game, he had Mike Williams and I had Dicker the Kicker. And it went from me being like 17% chance of winning all the way up to 100% as Dicker the Kicker helped me out. And my home field advantage helped me out as I took down Kevin 132.75 to 129.98. So less than 3 points separated the two semifinal matchups. So the number one seed, Tyler, moves on to face the number two seed, Brady Gaga. And let's look at our week four final Ruby Doobie Championship matchups. And we'll see who the computer is like in here. First of all, on our consolation ladder, we have Angie Lute versus Angie Krug. Right now, Angie Krug favorite 128-98. Nathan Neward, again, if you don't want Tyler on GR, drop him. Don't tell Tyler McDonald, though. Let me pick him up. Nathan's favorite 141-130 over Sheehan. You got the Teely. He's favorite 111-83 over Leanne. Nick's favorite 113-92 over Ryan. KP, his favorite over Fail Mary, 118.7 to 118. And Dora coming in hot, favorite big over Brad, 123-81. In the Ruby Ducey playoffs, which could end up in a four-way tie, we'd have to go to total points in the playoffs. The least total points would be the Ruby Ducey champion, last place in the league. You got Ankeny Natron, favorite over Michael Allen, 128 to 114. If Nathan loses that one, he's got three losses, and he is either the outright Ruby Ducey champ or Ruby Ducey champ, Ruby Ducey loser. I don't know what it'd be called, but he'd be the outright. And then you got Matt and Jeanette, Jeanette's favorite 104 to 102. If we would have a tie, we will go to that least points. In the third, fourth place matchup, you got Team Hawkeye and Becky Hosing. It's slated to be a good one right now. Becky's favorite 141 to 136. But to the main event, what we've all been waiting for since that day at the Chicken Coop with our draft, it is the Ruby Doobie Championship matchup between the number one seed, 10-3, Team McDonald, Tyler McDonald, and then number two seed, 10-3, Brady Gaga, coached by this guy in his retro gear, Steve Glenn. And right now, Tyler, he will get that 1 point home field advantage lead over me. I am favored 146 to 134. I don't know how that is happening. Tom Brady's scheduled to get 30 points. He's only gotten over 30 points once for me. It's going to come down to Brady. Going back to my game with Kevin this week, holy cow, like everything that I needed to have happen, happened. I text Tyler, I said, I needed Tom Brady to Rashid White touchdown here, and it happened. And only the second time all year it's happened. I needed some crazy stuff to happen, and it all came through for me. But I just need Tom Brady to get over 30 points for me and match what Kirk Cousins can do. I picked up the Falcons defense. I might be sketchy on that. Tyler's got the Tennessee defense. I got Jamar Chase, and he's got Amon-Ra St. Brown. I mean, we got some good teams going here. I don't know how I'm favored by so many. And Tyler asked me that earlier today, too. But it should be a good one. I'm trying to get to load up here. I still got a couple decisions to make on my lineup. As maybe it's loading, I might have to go to my phone here because I am at home tonight, as you can tell, and my home internet is not near as good as school's internet. But so here is the matchup. Tyler McDonald, he's got Nick Chubb. I guess we got it right here. He's got Nick Chubb, Chris Olave, might be out. Christian Kirk, Gabe Davis, Alvin Kamara, Titans D, and then my old kicker, Evan McPherson. Evan, I want to take you out just because you switched squads. I got Brady, Zeke Elliott, Jahan Dotson, Jamar Chase, Zay Jones, Amon-Ra St. Brown, Falcons, and Cameron Dicker, the Chargers kicker, trying to help me out here. Game times. I do have a couple Thursday games in there. I got Zeke Elliott. Then I got Tom Brady on Sunday, Jahan Dotson Sunday, Jamar Chase Monday night. That is nice to have him on Monday night, just in case I need it. But Tyler has Gabe Davis on Monday night and McPherson. So this one's going to come down to the wire as well. What a season it's been. Brady Gaga in the mix somehow. Again, I remember week three or week two or four, whatever it was, I played that fire song that I thought I was out. Still hanging around. I am a survivor. Tyler McDonald's been the computer favorite for weeks. The two best records in the league. I mean, what's better than this? Number one versus number two. I don't know how many people are still watching this video, how many of you two are still in, but it's going to be heated. Tyler and I also have a dinner on the line. I mean, man, what high stakes. We got dinner. We got trophies. We got everything going on here. It is the Ruby Doobie Championship, and you know how we do it. It is go Brady Gaga. Tyler, you're going down. We're going to leave you with what we always leave you with. It's the final countdown. Ruby Doobie Championship this week. The Gaga versus McDonald. Going down, Tyler. One more show. We're going to the championship. I'd like to do a trophy presentation this year. I did it last year. We'll have some videos. We'll put them up. I'd like to do that this year. Hopefully get that done. Do an award show. Present the trophy. Do some other awards. It is the final countdown. Ruby Doocy Championship. Go Brady Gaga. Go Brady Gaga. Tyler, you're going down.